Just to be more specific, kasi Congressman Atienza has been quoted in some reports as claiming that the tetanus toxoid or the tetanus vaccine has HCG, yung human chorionic gonadotropin, which
is not true.
He's supposed to be claiming is an abortifacient, or at least something that causes sterility. So is there truth to this, and what exactly is HCG?
HCG is actually human chorionic gonadotropin. Is a hormone that's related to pregnancy. It's produced by the placenta. So any lady who gets pregnant, immediately prior and after, during and after pregnancy, you have a high level of HCG. That's why we call it the hormone of pregnancy. And what happened is sometime in the mid-90s, I think it was in Kenya. So this was actually a big thing. It's like the dengue vaccine scandal that happened in the Philippines, the dengue vaccine scare. What happened during the time was a tetanus vaccine scare. And this was very prominent in Mexico, Nicaragua, Tanzania, Kenya, some areas in Africa, and the Philippines. So there was a group in Kenya who sued and accused the Kenyan government and the United Nations Children's Fund, UNICEF, that they were in cahoots in sterilizing women and causing miscarriages among Kenyan women. What actually happened there is, I think, three patients allegedly submitted samples to a laboratory. The laboratory tested the tetanus vaccine, and they were surprised to find out that it was laced with HCG. And they were saying that this high doses of HCG causes miscarriage and sterility. While very high doses of HCG can be related to miscarriage because it's actually the hormone in pregnancy. Mm-hmm. This was a very questionable event. Just like the PAU forensic laboratory that is not recognized by experts, this laboratory in Kenya is not recognized as an institution that can determine composition of vaccines. Mm. That's why...
For a layman, himay-himay po lang na natin.
Yes.
So una-una, does the tetanus vaccine have HCG,
no.
This controversial hormone?
No, I can give you all the documents that the World Health Organization has released to correct that misinformation. Kaya nga ang sinasabi ko, yung laboratorio na pinadalhan ng grupo na nag-akusa sa Kenyan government na yung tetanus ay para pang palaglag ng bata at pang sterilize ng mga babae, initinest daw dito sa laboratoryong ito. This laboratory, however, is not accredited. Kumbaga, sorry for the term, but it's like a fly-by-night laboratory.
Kung sa media,
okay. So, kaya ang pangalawa, what we discovered then was that the samples sent to the laboratory was actually blood samples. Kaya kami nagulat, because if you want to test a vaccine as contaminated, you should determine or examine the tetanus vaccine, not the blood of a patient.
Because the blood would have other elements involved already.
Not only that, if you're saying that this water is contaminated with poison or with toxin, you should examine this water. You should not examine the coffee in the other areas in this station. Kapareho nga ito ng dengue vaccine, they are examining dead people. But what you look for in the dengue vaccine, if it's not effective, is a complication of severe dengue. And severe dengue would have fever and a blood sample. Pag patay na, syempre wala nang dugo yun at wala rin lagnat kasi patay na siya. So ito naman yung dugo ng pasyente na nahulugan ang binigay sa laboratory at sinabi, oops, ang taas ng human chorionic gonadotropin. Kaya nalaglag kasi itong babaeng ito nagpabakuna. That's not based on science.
You were quoting a study or a survey that found 20 to 30% of the vaccines at that time containing HCG. May we know who undertook this study or survey, and was it a laboratory that is recognized by, for example, the United Nations or the WHO or anything to that effect?
At that time, I was very active in the pro-life movement as president of Pro-Life Philippines. And we sent boxes of vials of the vaccine to USP, laboratory, and Makati Med. So yun ang siguro dalawang institutions na yun. Sufficiente na para paniwalaan namin. At yun naman ay produkto rin ng aming pakikipag-usap sa lahat ng mga bansa na natitiktima ng population control. It has nothing to do with Congresswoman Garin. I'm really surprised why she reacted very violently about the issue.